game. They take away Nidalee, though. Fabula showed earlier on against Legacy why that Nidalee is probably worth a back.
Yes, definitely had a very good performance. We also saw Dark Passage. No, okay. We want to make sure we get a one-on-one lane. They got the one-on-one lane, and he used it to just punish Minky Will in that game. But let's see what else Russian Force want to get rid of. Kassadin being banned. Maokai is left open if Dark Passage wants him. Otherwise, they could go. Let's see, what else would they actually pick here?
What else would you need to pick apart from Maokai when it's open? And that's the problem being on the red side, where you have to get rid, really, of both Kassadin and Maokai, and then something as strong as Nidalee. And you might argue that Fabulous is going to feel just as confident by taking that Maokai into this game. On the other side, though, for Russian Force, looks like they're opting to go for their bottom lane in this one, taking the Ezreal and Nami lane.
So seeing some differentiated carries for Dayruin. A bit of a long-range poke lane here. You got some sustain from Nami. I want to see his mechanics on this Ezreal, because again, they were good on the Vayne. He tried to make plays. Here's the guy which basically everyone from Russian Force is trying to build their comp around, and then hope he gets some kills early and he can actually carry the game.
So, Braum, Lee Sin, then over for Dark Passage. Crystal M shown that definitely good with that Lee Sin. And Touch played a pretty mean Braum in that last one. They got off a good few combos to pick up kills, or, you know, the auto attacks in from the stuns to get kills for them. On the other side, Lulu going to be locked in here, along with Jarvan. Of course, we did see Lulu picked up earlier on today, actually, by Russian Force in their first game against Legacy, where they played it in the top lane with 80 remains. Jarvan as well will be returning into action. We saw him in our first game of the day. It was Dark Passage that played him there.
Yeah, so again for Dark Passage here with the Braum. It was really well played by Touch. He set up a lot of kills, especially also early on. Like, remember the level 2 kill he got onto Legacy as well, in the lane phase, onto Aegyem on the Morgana. But picks come in very fast, and surprise, surprise, Russian Force once again setting up to protect your AD carry. However, you don't have a hyper carry now. So in the late game, when you have Lulu, Zillion, and Ezreal, you could really run into a situation where you lack a lot of damage compared to the side of Dark Passage, where they have the Yasuo, who will scale really well into late game. And then you have this super tanky Maokai, who's just going to run in your face. And Ezreal was never really much of a tank killer either. You can, of course, still build play the Rune King. And the thing about Maokai as well is, if you don't use your E, you jump fast enough on Ezreal, Maokai will follow you.
Yeah.
Even though you use it and still get the slow onto you here. So I have to see what Russian Force can do. Once again, a lot of focus on getting Dayruin going. If he gets going, they have the comp to protect him. Zillion, you have Lulu top lane, but he needs to get the kills early on.
Well, we'll find out here soon. But now that those champions have been locked in, do you want to switch your vote? Tweet hashtag DPWin or hashtag RFWin to at LOL Esports. We'll see if those numbers change. 85%, I believe it was, to Dark Passage coming into this one. Russian Force, sadly for them, not being able to pick up a win so far here today.
No, and been some very one-sided games. And it often end up after like 15, 20 minutes. They keep trying to fight, but they're too far behind and just end up giving more and more kills, which is also why they've given like 45 kills one game to Dark Passage. They gave like 38 in the last game here to Legacy. So while it's big numbers, it's simply because instead of sitting back and waiting for you to get outscaled anyway, they just keep looking for the fights, hope they can outplay, hope they can make a miracle and get some kills.
So a quick note here, we are actually going to redo pick and bans, because the word that I'm hearing is that Russian Force actually did ban a third person. So we couldn't see it because our graphics showed up the no third ban, but apparently they did actually ban someone, which obviously could change how picks and bans work. So we're going to get into it.
True. If they want
to, there's another chance for Darker to actually, you know, reconsider and take his special choice.
Well, there's a high chance we see the same picks, unless they want to ban Maokai instead of Nidalee. Only change our team, maybe leave Kassadin open. Didn't work for them last time they did.
No.
So not sure what they want to change, if they still want to keep the Nidalee Kassadin banned. But let's wait and see.
Well, the question is, do you want to like just ban out what they just picked in that one? Maokai obviously is an example.
I mean, you
of
knew
that.
They were going to first pick Maokai anyway, so it's not like a surprise.
Well, yeah. If you leave Maokai open, he's obviously just going to go. And if they did ban a third one, which I'm not even sure what it was that they banned
Teemo
in the end. Teemo, obviously, yeah. such a strong pick right now, up against the tree in that top lane.
Would actually be a counter if you run a setup where it's all about your AD carry. He just like walks in, blinds your AD carry and walks out. GG Tactics.
Not sure if we're actually going to see a Teemo at any stage throughout games comp. I'd be very surprised if Teemo makes an appearance other than in a maybe a TSM ban list.
Could be. Could be. I mean, we did see Teemo once at Worlds last year. That's TSM true. Versus Mineski, I believe. Yeah. Reginal played Teemo. So there's still a chance we're going to see him. There's for sure some champions we've never seen at Worlds. 1-0 for Teemo.
Okay, so some developing news on the little story here. Actually, Dark Passage declined to have a remake of the picks and bans. So what actually happens is they said, okay, they banned a third champion, but we don't actually care about that. We're just going to play with this lineup. So we are going to remake the game, but it's going to be with the same bans and same picks.
That makes sense, because again, they will probably just pick exactly the same they did here.
Yeah.
Same goes for Russian Force. No reason really to change it up, and both teams probably just want to get the game on the way, see what's going to happen here. Once again, Russian Force. Your AD carry needs some kills early on, otherwise your combo is kind of going to fall apart.
Let's talk a little bit while we've got time here, while these picks and bans for the game actually get sorted out, about tomorrow, because going to be first up here on stage before we get into our fifth, sixth place game for the LCS later on. What do we think to a best of five between Dark Passage and Legacy? I mean, they've gone 1-1 here today.
Yeah, so we have seen in both the games where they played each other, Dark Passage would win the early game.
Yeah.
They did it in game one, and then it went completely wrong in team fights. And then the second game, they just got so far ahead and had this fast push come, and they didn't actually get these wrong team fights, and therefore just kept the lead. So Legacy needs to be careful tomorrow in the early game. They don't give up these leads here to Dark Passage, because they've shown they can take it. They showed in the game two against Legacy, they can also use it to just snowball it. Take tower, 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 finish the game. There's not much Legacy could actually do. What we have seen from Legacy, though, is some very good team fights, as long as they are somewhat even in gold. So it's going to be a lot about them picking some strong laners or avoid the fact that Dark Passage plays champs like Nidalee, which is very hard to deal with in a one-on-one, and make sure she's not going to get locked in. And if she does get locked in, you have to force the lane swap and not risk being in the same situation they were in the last game.
Well, so far, your tip for winning wildcard here is still in place. My dark horse choice of Russian Force, sadly, is not panning out as Joe Miller would have expected it to, sadly enough. But, guys, the picks have been redone here, so we are going to be getting into the game here shortly. And, of course, they will be staying the same as we saw before, which means a Yasuo versus Zilean in the mid lane. Naru's chance to show himself on a assassin this time around.
Yeah, normally Zilean is actually a very good pick against Yasuo. Pretty much a counter pick because of your ult. And also the fact in laning phase you can just bomb his face. Can't really block it with the wind wall.
Yeah.
Which is annoying for the Yasuo. So we have to see in these, if we do get team fights where they are fairly even in gold, if the ulti from Darker can kind of cancel out all the damage from the Yasuo and therefore try and lock him down and shut him down completely, which therefore could turn it in favor of Russian Force. But still, they rely so much on Dave Ruin to do well, and the early to mid game has to be perfect because they have to get the goal lead. They have a full mid game comb in their case with like both Zilean and Ezreal. Go full late game and you're going to lag a lot of damage, especially against Maokai.
Well, on that note then, let's get into our final game of the day. It is, of course, Dark Passage taking on Russian Force, and still a little bit on the line in this one, even though Dark Passage are through to tomorrow's best of five final against Legacy. Depends now on seed. If they win this game, because of the time ruling, they will finish top and get the choice of sides. And if they lose here to Russian Force, not only will it be Russian Force's single win of the day, but that means that DP then would be finishing in second, and Legacy, with a better score over today's round-robin stages, would get that first seed and choice of sides. Currently, Dark Passage look like they could be setting up for something a little bit tricky.
So again, we have seen a lot of level ones, a lot of invades that are hoping we're going to see an invade.
Oh, this could be really, really bad. There's Prom landing his Q, and he's going to get stunned up here. There's the dive in. Sun comes down. First blood for Crystal M. So that's the good start to the game you were talking about for Daeruin, right?
Right, yeah.
1 minute in.
Not exactly what I had planned when I was figuring out my plan of how Russian Force would win. He didn't even directly face check. He just kind of ran past them and they collapsed onto him and killed him. So not a good start for Russian Force. Flash is gone for Daeruin. which means Crystal M can just walk down if he wants to once he gets the double buff and try and force him out of the lane or pick up another kill.
And that's what happens as well when you skill very, very, very early on into the game. If you'd have waited as soon as he spotted him, put a point there in your jump and hop away with a flash as well, if really needed.
Yeah.
But he had already skilled up his Q, so that didn't really go well for him.
And we might see more
fights. Gonna see a face check from this one. Touch gonna spot him. Is it gonna get in there? He's gonna get stunned up once again. The ignite is burning now from Touch, and Dayrun is gonna go down again. Surely inside the brush, the ignite comes down from Archie there. Heal at the last second. Not enough to keep him alive. And the support's gonna bash heads a little bit. Don't think Touch is gonna have enough damage to actually finish Archie off here, but they will. Nonetheless, have a bit of a fight about it. And that's actually decent damage there from Touch coming out. But that leaves us 2-for-1 and Dayruin.
Well, twice.
Two deaths in 2 minutes.
Yeah, and you don't really want to fight a Lucian Braum at level 1 because of the double tap from Lucian and the stun. Like, there's a very, very high chance you're going to get stunned very fast. And
can't miss it.
No, you can't really miss it. And I'm pretty sure Holy Phoenix could have actually finished Dayrun without dying here. First of all, he delayed his heal a lot. And he didn't use it before, or he used it while the Ignite was on him. And at the same time, he might actually switch over to Archie before he finished Dayrun here. Otherwise, got the kill. Dayrun didn't get a kill, went over to Archie. So in that case, it goes in favor, of course, of Dark Passage.
So how does that leave us here?
It's going to leave us at a level 2 gank.
Yeah, it is. Dementia actually coming down towards his bottom lane. What's he going to be able to do? Holy Phoenix going to be waiting out here. He's going to flash away with the dash as well. And Touch was just able to jump to him and not really too much of a problem there. Jarvan coming down will obviously go straight back into his jungle now to get himself those buffs that he obviously skipped a little bit there for that level 2 gank, but just trying to get this bottom lane back into the swing of things because early on they started to fall quite the margin behind. But if we actually look at gold now, 11-6 up in CS with that single assist over with Dayruin, they're actually very close still on gold.
Yeah, I like their idea from Russian Force just to like level 2 gank, try even a level 1 just to see what happens and to do whatever you can. Archie, my friend, can you survive?
Well, I'm not sure that he can.
Yes,
oh,
he
the
can.
Dunk from the
no,
cube, but Crystal just flashes in for it.
Yes,
here
he can.
Comes Jarvan up from the side. Touch is going to go low. Has to flash. Can Dayruin get in there and finish him off? Crystal M dashes out to Holy Phoenix. And would you believe it? They've managed to survive, at least for now.
Oh, the
Dayruin going to be a man.
No, where
gonna
is
be
it?
A man.
Oh.
He's going to take turret hits. They're turning it around.
No,
you know,
Dayruin.
Back in, and Dayruin is going to go down. Archie, you can't get away either. And just like that, two kills. Three kills,
Kasnara
is there.
So
disaster
close.
For Russian Force.
It was so close. You're like, oh, he survived. They can get a kill. And then Dark Passage completely ruined the fun. I just walked down, picks up 3 kills here. Once again, the mid laner against Darker always seems to be able to roam to the other lane. Now Darker is actually on a zillion.
Yeah, exactly.
And we're just going to see again because today Rune here, he wants to be a man. He wants to get the kill. Braum, of course, is very, very manly, and being annoying as he is with the shield, blocks the skill shot, he dies, Yasuo joins in, picks up a kill, and now Archie's left all alone.
And double buff for Yasuo as
double
well.
Double buff as well. Well, it's almost like we've seen this situation before. A lot of early action in the bottom lane, and then four members from the other team is instantly in your face and just kills you.
And Naru here, ahead on CS, we were talking about how Darker has a bit of an easier time there because he can keep that distance as soon as Yasuo steps forward, put the bomb, and it can't be blocked by the wind wall. But Darker's actually falling behind here in CS. And it obviously depends how aggressive you play as Yasuo as well. If you just dive on him constantly,
true,
gonna force him out of lane, force him to use that mana pool up very, very quickly. And we see that that's working out. Top lane, Fabulous did go low there also. Talk 80 remains pretty
there's
low. Meanwhile, down in the bottom lane, they're going to go for Archie once again. Where's the stun? There it is. Crystal M coming around the side. Is the damage there? Dayruin taking damage in as well. One more auto attack will do it. Holy Phoenix picks up that one. Is it going to be a duel? Flash away. They decide not to follow.
All the focus onto Archie here. And Dayruin can't do anything to help him. I mean, Archie's just left splashing by himself and he will just die every single time they gank. Now, onto Naru in mid lane. Level 6. Well, it wasn't really a gank. It was more like, hey, I'm here.
Yeah, just showing up, maybe trying to force him out and give Darker a bit of a respite because Currently 30 CS behind, and Naru not too bothered about those bombs that keep coming his way. Meanwhile, top lane Fab Fabulous has just come back into lane with that Catalyst and Protector, and you see going straight in onto 80 remains, ultimate running. Don't think it's going to turn into anything too serious there, though. Just for the fact that it is Malkia's touch. Going to get bubbled up. Can Dayruin finish him off this time? It's Archie that takes the brunt of the damage back from Holy Phoenix. That's double door. Oh, Archie in trouble. And Holy Phoenix going to finish him off. Dayruin going to try and come out, but he will himself get stunned up. Has he got the damage to throw back? Summon a heal. Not enough. Double for Holy Phoenix.
Dayruin really likes to be aggressive. He supports dies. And he's like, yeah, no, I'm not done yet. He jumps in between two members from Dark Passage, gets stunned, dies as well. Now, once again, this is not a gank, guys. It's just checking, okay, what's going to happen in lane? Okay, I'm just showing I'm here, and then I'm backing away.
Well, nowhere near strong enough to kill him anyway, I think that. And probably would have just ended up giving another kill over to Holy Phoenix, who's having another one of those games. Tristana, of course, it was earlier on where he managed to get a pentakill. He's 5-1-1 after just 7.5 minutes here as Lucian.
And normally, in a Protect AD Carry comp, if your AD Carry has died 4 times at 7 minutes,
your comp's not working out.
It's going to be harder. It's, again, you can still be done, but it doesn't exactly make it easier.
Well, it makes it so that you're protecting with less resources, an AD carry that's not as powerful.
Yes, and it doesn't give as much gold to the other teams. In that case, it actually pays off. And you just want to give yourself a challenge.
Well, certainly is a challenge at this point. You see the Cutlass, double daggers coming in. A lot of tankiness, two touch already, and they're going to go once again towards Dayruin. Can they lock him up here? Actually, pretty much everything missing Dayruin there, so he's just able to turn away and walk off from things. And Naru, in the meantime, he's just looking what he's got to pick up on the top side of the map. Going to go in towards 80 remains. Demetra is coming, so Naru decides it's time to run away. We will see the Glitterlands come in. Nicely blocked there in the end by that Windwall. And he can just simply saunter away from any problem, and Crystal M gets himself some stolen farm out of the jungle. Demetra might get the same though by the blue buff here.
Getting the blue buff. Let's see if Crystal M wants to go down to this bottom lane though after he's taken the blue buff away from Russian force. The lane is already pushed in. There is flashes though on Dayruin. Let's see what he wants to do. He's pinging it. It's probably a good sign.
What? Don't think he's actually awarding that brush there, so it's not going to be spotted out. And looks like they may just... There is a ward being put
prediction,
down.
Prediction, triple kill
doesn't really mean anything, though. They're going to go straight towards Dayruin. He's going to get locked up behind his turret.
That didn't work.
That's tanking up the tower. And Archie says, nope, I'm not sticking around. Sorry, my friend, I'm going to have to leave you to die once again. However, Darker is headed down. Jarvan's coming just behind him. But Darker needs to be a little bit careful about this one. Yasuo will be following, will be a little further back. Oh, there's the ultimate out of touch, actually knocks up both of them, but Cataclysm is slammed down on towards touch. Crystal M dives in, gets the kill onto Demetra anyway. And where did Lucian come from? I didn't even realize that Holy Phoenix is still behind them. Darker's gonna try and get away. Exhaust is put onto Holy Phoenix, but the bomb's not gonna be enough. Ultimate is used. Holy Phoenix, Crystal M gonna set up there. The Q actually missing from Crystal M. I'm not sure that it'll really matter. Actually, Darker using a last second flash is going to get
away.
No, he's dead. Yeah. Wrong officio. The Q landed from Crystal M, who's now 5-0-1.
And this Lee Sin was banned against him earlier today. Was actually left over by Legacy. He did a good job on Lee Sin. Very aggressive plays early on. Doing the same here. Just always running down to this bottom lane. They notice action. They notice someone's gone. We're just going to see once again. Dagger comes in. Remember, he has no Ignite. He has an Exhaust because he's against the Yasuo now. Yeah, so pretty easy pick up first. There's no ulti from Dagger onto Jarvan, even though he actually goes down. Now it's just a matter of time while they are chasing him. Gets the ulti out of Dagger. Wants to kill him. And this happened about 10 seconds ago, so I'm pretty sure people remember. Dagger almost escaped. And then Crystal M is like, not on my watch.
And actually what I didn't notice that Naru, before this kill here, during that last fight, actually went through the enemy jungle. Archie somehow had backed away to there, and He managed to get a kill onto Archie. So that leaves now, after that kill in the top lane, 3-0-0 Yasuo, 5-0-1 Lee Sin, 5-1-4 Lucian. They're going to try for a dragon here. And there is Touch trying to steal it away, but it is taken by Demuncher. So what are they going to do now? Trying to focus Touch. That's a good bubble coming in. It's going to be decent damage coming out, and they'll get the CC in there as well. It's actually the second kill of the game so far, 15-2 in kills. It's still a very long road back here for Russian Force if they pick up a single win here today.
I mean, they did get the dragons, so got some global gold, which always helps. Darko showing the moves, dancing around the queue from Crystal M. Top lane, however, Holy Phoenix is just pushing it. Already has his blade completed, 5 kills, 11 or 12 minutes into the game. He's probably not complaining.
No. Everyone really getting everything far too early, in all honesty. Rod of Ages was done, I think, around the 11-minute markers. We may see Holy Phoenix in a little bit of trouble here. He's stuck inside the Cataclysm. We'll actually sidestep there away from the True Shot Barrage, but Demetra is able to pick up the kill, but here comes Crystal M, gets one. They decide 80 remains might not be killable at this point, but they might collapse onto that mid lane. That Rod of Ages, Maokai is not going to be scared to Twisted advance right underneath the tower, and they know it. They've decided to leave it and give up this inner turret.
Yeah, so they don't even mind trading like one for one, as long as they can push down the towers. Because it's no longer about the kills now for Dark Passage. It's just all about getting down these towers, getting the base, getting inhibitor down. It's kind of weird to say it. 12 minutes into the game, it's all about now the towers and getting in the base of the enemy team. But they already have enough kills on the carries. They already have the first set of items, going to get the second one next time they actually do go back. And Archie, you're in trouble.
Archie is possibly going to go down here. Tidal Wave comes out before he falls. And actually, he's still alive there in the back. Naru will try and escape, and I think does live through it. Daerun being chased. Crystal M will get one. Is he going to go deep and try for another one? No, they're just going to wait here and finish off that tower, which is what they came for in the first place. Naru managed to stay alive. They took out Jarvan, and that will be, after 13 and a half minutes, almost a 10,000 gold lead.
Right, and Trinity Force from a day ruin is not exactly going to be there very soon.
No.
Then again, we can have a protect their Sylvian comp instead, because he has a kill. Or protect a fish.
Well, he can protect Zillion, but he's got a tier up until now, and an Amp Tome as well.
Yeah, yeah.
Not exactly full of damage at this stage. Compare that to his opposite number, who Static Shiv, Berserker Greaves, and a Pickaxe now for Naru at 3-0-1. Lee Sin is miles ahead of Jarvan on itemization. And even if we look towards the top lane, yes, the themes was done. Can he land the bubble here? Damage is going to be turned around and going on towards Daerun. That's a lot of damage back coming in from Holy Phoenix. There's the culling. It's not actually hit. Oh, it is. It's hitting Daerun at the back. Here comes Crystal M as well. Archie going to be focused. Holy Phoenix is still alive there at the back as Naru will now join in, trying to get Darker away from everything. His ultimate was thrown in somewhere. I didn't actually see where. And that is just like that. Four men going down. Holy Phoenix managed to escape.
So we did see recent gaming all of a sudden. Russian Force try one of their ganks once again. They have a lot of names today, Special Force as well. Backfired. The last Q actually from AT Remains was blocked by Touch and his shield, I believe, and therefore he didn't manage to kill Holy Phoenix. He stayed alive. We're just gonna see it again. First the gank from Archie, Daerun joins in. Just dancing around, dodges everything. There's a lot of damage. Culling as well, AT Remains comes in, pops the E onto him. Wants to kill him, he's a shield, and actually, shield from Touch.
Yeah.
Blocked it. Holy Phoenix stays alive, and now the rest of Dark Passage can just clean it up.
I think Darker actually put his ultimate on himself there.
Yeah, it's protect. It's a Sicilian comp.
Oh yeah,
we just talked about it. Come on, Joe.
That's true. Kind of forgot about that one. We're going to see another fight. Crystal M, legendary, 8-0-4. True Shot Barrage, not quite as legendary. They just go straight past, and now Darker, he's going to have his ultimate available. No, he's not. He didn't even use it.
Oh, well. Onto the base again. Still all about the base here.
Oh, Daerun.
Come on, win it!
He's not even trying.
Unlucky.
He just stands there and lets Holy Phoenix finish him off. And that will be 7 kills on the AD carry, 7 on the mid laner, 8 on the jungler. It's going to be even more here. AT Remains going to be the focus. Fabulous taking a lot of damage. Naru gone too deep in this one, and AT Remains ticking away. Heal's not enough. Naru will pick himself up his 8th kill. And we're 16 minutes into this game. I had to check the clock because there's quite a lot of kills, 23-4 in fact. And Dark Passage have already got Russian Force inside of their own base.
Still though, I have to give respect to Russian Force for the fact they keep trying to fight. I mean, they keep just going, but they know they can just sit back and wait. They want to go for it again. Daerun just jumping in. If they do manage to pick up some kills, you never know what's going to happen. So I respect the fact they keep trying to fight. Also makes the game a bit more exciting, other than just pick like full wave clear comp, sit in your base for 45 minutes, and just wave clear. Nope. They want to fight. They want to get kills, and they want to complete an item.
Oh, Holy Phoenix actually is going to be met by Darker on the top side. That's a good amount of damage. Back, he's got his ulti though. The bomb's not enough to actually finish him. Holy Phoenix going away. True Shot Barrage missions. There's
one more.
Exhaust comes down. That's surely going to be enough. Oh, he does go down. The rest of the team have just collapsed in there. And the rest of Dark Passage are saying, what are you doing, Holy Phoenix? We're doing Dragon down here.
Still though, Darker got a kill here. Probably worth more than the Dragon actually itself.
True.
Just to get the kill. Let's see what he's going to spend his well-earned gold on.
Morella Normicon,
in your face, Holy Phoenix.
Yeah, we'll see how effective it turns out to be for him.
I really wish his name was actually Holy Felix.
Why is that then?
Sounds pretty cool.
Holy Felix. Maybe if you have a chat to him, he'll think about renaming just for you. Not sure that's going to work though. Naru going to catch out Darker. Knock up ultimate. You are dead and you're not using your ultimate again. It's actually on cooldown this time. I'll let him off.
Yeah, I was also knocked up in the air. I'm tied really, really fast here. Let's see. Jarvan is sneaking in from behind.
Oh.
It's actually not sneaking because...
No, he's just actually stood there, but he's managed to get the knock-up on both of them. The Unbreakable from Touch is only going to get him so far. There's the ultimate out of Touch. True Shot Barrage blocked by the Wind Wall, and they turn the damage back towards Jarvan. Naru's onto him. The Mecha's going down. Naru gets the killing spree. And I think that might be all, unless Daeruin tries really, really hard again to get a kill. Oh, there's the kick on Daeruin. Rooted up straight into Maokai's path. Got the ultimate out of Darker as well.
He's going to go
man mode. Goes diving in on top of him. There is the shutdown onto Lee Sin. Naru off to the side, not pushing in up until now. There he comes. Holy Phoenix is there as well. Darker got no ultimate, and that's a double kill for Holy Phoenix. Knock up and ulti onto 80 remains. Naru only needs one more hit, and he gets it with the knock up as well.
Still, they kill Crystal M. He tried to make the big plays. Got some style points for the kick flash. End up actually dying for it, but then the rest of the team just joins in and finish off. And now they're into the base. Let's see. Come on, Archie. Kill him.
Well, the turret's going down, whatever happens. And I think that Dementia, well, yeah, he's going to follow. Maokai gets his first kill, actually, of the game here for Fabulous. At 1-0-11, and it's also going to be the first inhibitor taken down. Of course, they all spawn in about 20 seconds, since we're only 20 minutes into the game.
That is correct. Making it just a little bit harder once you actually get some kills to push in. But I guess there are 15% who voted for Russian Force to win. Might want to change the vote.
Oh, this could be real bad news for Darker. Going to get slowed down. Tidal Wave comes over and Touch says, no, I'll block that out. What are you going to do? Bubble went to the backside and look at this. They're starting to close in. Touch might be in trouble. Holy Phoenix going to throw the call in towards 80 remains and Daeruin. Not exactly masses of damage and Daeruin chasing through. Not sure why he's going for the support here. Should have probably focused. Holy Phoenix, who gets hit by the True Shot Barrage. Can he escape this one? Darker loses vision for a second. And he does have his ulti on, and Holy Phoenix should just turn around here and have a go at him. Almost takes him with him, but Darker does get the kill. Actually, no, it was Lulu that got the kill. Here comes the rest of Dark Passage, though. They're going to go, first of all, at the back onto Archie. Then they take down Jarvan. Darker is super low. Daeruin getting hit there by Naru, and this is going to be an ace. Double kill coming in for Maokai. first ace at 21 minutes, and that gives Dark Passage now only 20 seconds even to get in there and push these super minions through.
Yeah, they can't really do anything because they have to run to the base, and Russian Force is up in about 20 seconds, so 10 seconds actually. So keeping the defense going for now. While
the chance is still there though. I'll talk about it in a second. Look at Holy Phoenix almost taking Darker with him there. From this point on, it's a pretty simple cleanup. Crystal M actually getting bubbled. And just watch the damage as Naru comes flying in the back, getting himself one there. Finished off by Maokai, and a simple 5-4-1 in the end. They do have a chance though here, because Lulu now has an Omwrecker.
Which means you always have a chance. Unless your jungler dies, and he died.
Yeah. Gets knocked up there, Naru.
Now you don't have a chance.
13-1-5 here for Yasuo. He's gonna stand behind the wind wall, going straight in on towards Dayrun, and he's gonna go down as well. Good
don't
kill.
Him.
Actually,
don't
he's
kill
got
him.
The ulti on. They
no.
do kill him in the end. I don't think they wanted to, though. It looked like they'd completely focus away from him. There's the exhaust coming out. The knock-up not quite landing. Turning straight on towards Darker. He gets finished off. Naru actually going a little bit low there. And Dayruin's gonna try and come in and snipe him one. Meanwhile, Crystal M had chased Lulu all the way down the middle of the lane. And the Cullin catching on towards Dayruin. Is it gonna be enough? Sapling thrown over as well. Touch, gonna go in there. It's Holy Phoenix that sniped him off though. And that is another three kills. With Naru even trying to kill off those Nexus turrets with two men still alive for Russian Force. Mm-hmm. But either way, middle inhibitor turret goes down, knock up. And Touch finishes that one. And one by one, they're picked off.
With all these kills here for Dark Passage, it actually means our graphics tomorrow for the final, we're going to have some pretty sick KDAs to show. Really highlight how dominant these teams have been.
That's
against Russian Force. So it's going to look good in the graphic.
Oh, Darker inside of the base, getting some healing back. But I think the Dark Passage might want to finish the game here, right here and right now. Or maybe they'll just go for the fight. Actually, Darker goes down, but he had his ulti running. Dayruin also going very, very low. But the super minions pretty much doing the job. Fabulous will go in there as well. Oh, no! One hit needed onto the Nexus, and they've killed
a super minion as well.
Wow. Well,
it's not over yet.
The dream is still alive for Russian Force.
Look at the Nexus healing.
Little did people know that the Omwrecker is also used for defending last second Nexuses as well. Doesn't usually work out quite as perfect as it did there for Russian Force. Oh, there's a ward. Teleports up for Fabulous.
Yeah, still the Nexus is healing and they're already in the base. And it's a Maokai. I'm not really sure he's going to kill it.
I don't know, man.
Let's see.
He's got his Zhonya's and an extra blast.
Oh, that's TP. Okay, okay. Come on.
Okay.
What can you do?
He's going for it. TP to the top. Oh, he's going to run straight for it. Has Dayruin got the damage? There's the tidal wave coming through. Twisted advance onto it.
One more hit.
Needs one more hit to be the hero. And he gets it as well. And Dark Passage pick up the win here in 24 and a half minutes.
I'm not even sure what to say. Because it was just very one-sided from the start. Dark Passage knew they had to win the game to secure their number one seed, and can now choose if they want blue side or red side, or which order they want them for tomorrow's final against the Legacy Esport.
So I'm being told actually that I was wrong all day. Thanks, Fischio. That the times from earlier don't actually count. It's going to be a coin flip to decide who gets to choose red side or blue side, obviously. And if we look back to LCS playoffs, we had a couple of different ideas on which side you want to be playing red and blue, which games.
True.
One thing's for sure though, we've seen both teams today, both Legacy and Dark Passage, destroy Russian Force.
Yes.
And they've also had a couple of, well, they played each other twice, obviously, double round robin. Both games were actually pretty one-sided.
Yeah, agree. So if we just like completely ignore the fact that Russian Force, the games they have played now, and it's only competitive to teams, we talked about it before this game, how Dark Passage has been the stronger team in the early game, while Legacy, as long as they don't fall too far behind, at least in game one, were very, very good in team fights and managed to actually just win every single fight against Dark Passage and take the game.
Yeah.
So tomorrow's final here, as I said before, it's gonna be a lot about the early game and how Legacy can respond to the strong early game from Dark Passage, because they have some very good laners, the mechanics for the, on the players, like Holy Phoenix, fantastic mechanics, Nauru in the mid lane as well. So it's going to be hard for Legacy to handle this early game, but if they do, I feel like they can easily take it in team fights.
Just to quickly run down the scoreboard and, you know, let them have their props for that one. 3-1, 14 Maokai, not many kills, but he was the hero at the end who TP'd in and finished off the Nexus when it looked bad for Dark Passage. You know, if he didn't do that, they might not have won the game.
I was getting nervous.
11-8 Lee Sin for Crystal M. I mean, he got off to a flying start. Obviously, they picked up the first blood and then the second kill straight away, and they pretty much
like five kills.
Yeah, they didn't really stop coming. 14-7 Nauru actually on Yasuo. 10-5-9 for Holy Phoenix. So although he got off to a brilliant start, he kind of slowed down, died a couple of times, maybe just having a lot of fun.
Slacking
there
a little bit, you could say, to be honest.
I don't think so. And 1-1-22 for the support. So Touch doing fantastic job in there as well. Obviously, this game, not too much on the line for them, apart from, you know, finishing 3-1 in the day. Same as Legacy means that we get that coin flip, which will be done backstage to decide who gets to choose which side going into tomorrow's final.
Yes, I agree.
DeFicio agrees, everybody. We're doing something right, even though I've been lying to you all day about who actually gets to choose those sides. So sorry about that one. That will, of course, be our first best of five tomorrow. And we talk about coin flips to decide seeds. That's the kind of game, because we saw two one-sided matches here today that you would almost say is a 50-50, a coin flip, if you like, as to who's actually going to come out on top of that one. One thing we do have to consider is that, of course, the teams have time now this evening to go back, watch the games, pinpoint what went right, what went wrong for them, and also maybe change a few things.
Could definitely see some changes in picks and bans. Again, the Nidalee pick from FabFabulous against Legacy was a big issue, could potentially ban it away. And then they need to find out how to deal with this early game in the bottom lane where they have been looking shaky. So obviously there's a lot of things to work on, picks and bans, you have to sort it out for a whole best of five. You can't just sit and say, okay, for game one we play this and then we don't care about the rest. That's not how it works. I mean, you need to have some backup plans ready. You need to be ready for the situation where champion like Kassadin is left open. Because we saw Super Hot Crew against Rocket in the EULCS quarterfinals, where game one, Kassadin was left open by Rocket, and all of a sudden Super Hot Crew was like, okay, first pick it, and the rest of the comments made no sense compared to the Kassadin, and they end up losing the game without Kassadin doing anything. So you always have to be careful. You don't get baited into like, okay, this one champion, we know he's very, very strong. We want to pick him even though we didn't plan it. A lot of stuff, of course, to prepare.
Well, that